Hi, good day, good morning. You know, it's been an interesting week. Had a couple of challenges, some emotional traumas. I think sadness is just a part of life. We have to embrace it. Sometimes we gotta go through it. We gotta connect to people in our lives that help us to transition past it. And those are the things that hold us, keep us. But what's most important is you continue to take your vitamins, you continue to move, you continue to connect to your happy place. You gotta, because otherwise you won't have a happy place. So this morning I am focusing on my vitamins because I need them. You say, what vitamins? My daily essentials. Check me out. Just put in daily essentials, but go to my webpage, www.shop.com/Jedda, and you will be a customer of mine, and I will send you a 15% coupon off so you can try these wonderful vitamins. If you want a sample, just text me. So I'm going to get my energy up by finishing up my vitamins, and let's get ready. Go ahead and get your chair. You might want to get two cans today. Get your water. See, I got my water sitting over there. And let's begin, right? Okay. And praise God, my wonderful granddaughter. She's a pleasure. She always helps me with my music. And it's back on my watch. So let's start from the beginning. There we go. All right. So let's start. We're going to open up this morning with a great warm-up because you know what? We need it. I'm already feeling great. One thing about these vitamins is if you drink them within 20 minutes, they go to your cells. And guess what? There's no pills. You don't have to digest it in your stomach. It goes directly. It's 95% soluble within 20 minutes. So multivitamin, 4 vitamin B complex, complete our famous OPC3 antioxidant. Look it up, it's phenomenal. And calcium. So let's start with just massaging our hands, because that's important. Massaging our bodies, waking them up. Yeah. And we're going to start with our first opening, Tai Chi opening. Okay, you ready? Which is right fist into open left palm, right under the left under the right, open up, gentle bow. Rolling up through your lower spine, mid-back thoracic area, neck, shoulder, neck, head. Inhale up for commencing form. Remember, never locking the knees, always keeping them soft. Let's do it again, okay? But we're going to do it this time. I'm going to do it in the chair for my friends that are sedentary. Okay. Right fist into open left palm. Right under the left. Left under the right. Open up. Gentle bow. Rolling up through your lower back, mid-back, thoracic area, shoulders, neck, head. Inhale up. And exhale. Sometimes when you're going through a lot of grief or sadness, a lot of that sadness and stuff gets caught up with all the toxins. It's caught up in the joints. You gotta release it, free it, so that it doesn't cause us pain, because that hurts too. Our arms. I love this one. Just crisscross your arms if you feel better. I can't do it this way, but I'm doing this way. Just crisscross it. Just chest muscle. How about your stomach? Starting to see some toning in this little belly move. I would like to do some sit-ups, and maybe we'll do some of that on this channel. Figure out how to do it on the floor and how to do it in your bed. If you're going to do it in your bed, which is really great, this massage down the side of the legs. Be able to put your feet on the wall. It's really a great
other leg. If you can get your glute, get that in there. Pick up one glute and then switch over to your other leg. There you go. We're waking up the body. You know, it takes about 90 seconds for the body to even recognize that it's woke. I'm woke. Yeah. Let's just try that again. Remember all your nerve endings from your back, feeling back in your spine, your kidneys, all and in your feet. Do some more research, read more about your feet and things you can do. You know, just a massage. We gotta take care of our bodies. See only what we got. We'll be stuck in this shell for about, you know, however long we live. Like some Miss Hattie's turning 100. Yay! She's lived 100 years in that shell. So, trust me, if you don't take care of it, it's going to treat you how you treat it. We don't want to treat it bad. So, let's treat our bodies wonderful. Get those feet woken up. And then let's just crack right into some wonderful chi taps. In our arm of our bodies. Start with our left arm. Let's try that. Inside of the arm. Let's try the outside. Nice taps. So I'm going to be filming a show with the Hofford Public Library and Hofford Public Schools in a couple of weeks. May 5th, exactly. And guess what? It's about joy. And I'm thinking about it. It really is. How do we find joy? So I guess they're tying me up. How do we find joy in our Tai Chi? Let's take it across the chest. Ready? Give me some verbalization. Good morning. We're just starting. And we're just waking up our body. So come on and join us. Yeah. I got two little bumps on my shoulders because I keep carrying heavy stuff. And my body's like, oh, I have to build up stuff here because guess what? You're just making it hard for me. So stop making it hard for your body. Yeah. How about across the chest? Down your front of your abs. I'm so astonished. I've been exercising about 3 times a week, mostly 2 times a week, consistently with you. All the way down inside of the thighs. But also, I have been making my point to try to do some kind of exercise during every day. Every day. Let's get the outside. The back of your glutes. Come on. Television shows and not exercising at the same time. Are you out of your mind? But that's the best time to exercise. You gonna watch your favorite show? Squeeze those glutes. Do some leg lifts. Do some bicep curls. Come on. You said it. Just let it go. Woo. Whoa. I'm gonna tell you right now, my air conditioner's down. My windows have been up all night and I can tell that the heat is increasing because, let's take it right into a chi swing for me. If you're standing, just shift your body. Shift through one knee, then shift. So you gotta shift, boom, shift. Try not to lock them and stuff. Yeah, just shift. If you're in the chair, it's a little different. You guys kind of sit kitty corner. You're not gonna be able to really touch your kidneys unless you got rid of the back of that chair. It's gonna be a little challenging. A stool would be great if it didn't move. A wooden stool with a wide seat. That would be my choice. I might have to get one of those. Get 2 chairs, you know. Let me try. See a little chi swing going on in here. Yeah. Let this top hand just kind of hit the top of your shoulder where a lot of that stress hits. Your back hand is hitting where your kidneys are. It's actually waking the kidneys up. This is a chi swing in the chair. Let's take it right into a monkey bear. If you're in the chair, you want to kind of sit back a little bit. Monkey bear is swinging with the upper part of your body, but the lower part of your body is kind of heavy. You can pick up your feet, or you can just pick up to the ball of your foot. It's a choice. It's a monkey bear. It's created by by Scott Cole, my teacher. He's awesome sauce. And he's a great guy. Inhale. Beautiful. Nice. Now let's just gonna get our heart rate up just a little tad. Beautiful. Let's just take that right into a grounded chi. Now, grounded chi means you don't move the legs, you just move. Said you were gonna do, and even if you fall off one day, go right back to it the next day. That's why say work out every day because maybe there's going to be a day you ain't going to work out. And that day, you'll have to go back the next day and you get started. But every day that you make the effort, inhale, exhale, is the point. Inhale, exhale. And so now what we're going to do is take our left foot, our yin, the female star. I was wondering why he kept starting on the left. I was like, that's so unnatural. Because in dance, we always start on the right. But I didn't know that in Tai Chi posture, the left side represents the female side. So you're going to just take that. You're going to start with your left palm. It's facing the right hand. Exhaling. Inhale. Now you're going to let that right hand just float lightly over top. This is wonderful in the water. It really is. I can't wait till I start back into my aqua aerobics. Exhale. Shifting. You're also shifting through the legs in this one. Yes. Shifting. See how I'm shifting? I'm shifting through my waist. I'm shifting through my hips. I'm shifting through my legs. Yeah, take our time. We're not in a rush. Let that hand float over. I'm going to take it to the chair. So in the chair, guess what? My left leg is facing me. Your left leg is facing me and your right leg is facing me. You're just going to let that float. Throwing that waist, look at me, I'm losing waist. I'm gonna take my arms out of this just for a minute. Look, my waist. I'm using the waist, I'm using my stomach, I'm using my abs. The arms are just a flare. We were talking about that when I went to England when I was about 12 or 13. Exhaling, inhale, let that hand float over. I was looking for some pants. I was like, oh, I want some straight leg pants. They're like, straight legs? What are you talking about? It was like straight leg pants. You know what they called them? Stove pipes. In, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Yep, they called them stove pipes. I didn't know what they were talking about. They showed me some bell bottoms. I was like, those are bell bottoms. They're like, no, those are flats, flats. One more time. How you feeling? Inhale. We're gonna flow today, all right? Beautiful. And just open up your arms. They discovered that opening up your arms like a bird is a wonderful heart exercise. Inhale, exhale. Beautiful. Now just take it. We're gonna go right into flying bees. Inhale up. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. You can also shift if you like. Inhale. Shift to the right. Inhale back to the center. Exhale to the left. Inhale back to the center. Yes. You have choices in this world. Choose the one that is up the back. I like how the Princess Megan said, the lava. She didn't say yes, she just said, whatever you said before, that was what it was. Inhale. You can shift over to your right. Yeah, completely. Make sure you put the weight on that right foot. And remember, don't lift your foot up high and your back wants to do this. Collapse. No good. That's a waste of an exercise. Just don't do it, man. Every time I lift my leg up in the chair, I'm really engaging my ass because it takes a lot not to collapse that back. Let's take it again. I'm going to go back. Let's go back to center. You ready? We're standing. Inhale. We're in open horse stance to the right. Remember, you can leave your foot where it is. Inhale. And shift. Or you can bring it in. That feels better to me. Inhale. This is called flying geese. This is a posture called flying geese. If you want to take it to the high level, level up, level up, level up, they say. So they say in pokey words. Leveling up means you take it in there. I'll take you there. This is wonderful because it also helps with balance. That's what's so great about Tai Chi. You're shifting your weight over slowly, but also engaging balance. We need balance. That's what helps us from not falling. When we learn how to balance, learn how to move your body in space. Inhaling right here, exhaling. Last one, inhale. Beautiful. Lovely. All right. Let's shake that out. Take it right into that chi flow again. Inhale, exhale. Good. And now what we're gonna do is just take it right into bending bear. So slightly bend those knees. Just let your body do what it do. Just let your body go where it goes. Stop pressure. Stop trying to direct traffic. You know, that's that type A that Mr. Scott Will talks about. That type A syndrome. And I gotta tell you what to do, blah, 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 blah. You can't listen. You wanna always direct stuff. Stop directing. Let it go, let it go, let it go. Slowly inhale. Exhale. Beautiful. Just let your body hang out here for a minute. Slowly rolling up. Lower spine, erectus spinae, mid-back thoracic area, right where your shoulders are. Your shoulder, your neck, and arms for commencing form. This is commencing form. Let's take a few right here. I want you to sit in your commencing form. Inhale. And when you're coming up slowly, exhaling, put the weight on the outside of your feet. Push down into your feet a little bit. Inhale. Hands are coming in towards your body. I'm going to do it this way. Side view. Inhale. See, I'm sitting in my glutes. And exhale. Engaging the gluteus maximus. That's the way. I like it. Inhale. If you're in a chair, with your body, it's also going forward if you're sitting. You're up on top of those ischias. Remember we talked about the ischias? It's a small little bone about this big in your gluteus. When you're convexed, like pushing your bottom out to the back, that means you are before your ischias. If you are sinking your lower spine, like slouching, that's behind your ischias. Inhale. So use that stomach muscle right here. Good. Beautiful. Let's just take it now. Bending bear. We're going to take it nice back to a chi flow. We're going to take bending bear now over to the yin side, our left side. Ready? And let your body go. Let it go. Let it do what it do. I like that part. He always says that. Let your body do what it do. And inhale. And exhale. Just relax in it. Yeah. Inhale and exhale. Yeah, I had a high time last week. I decided to engage in St. Patty's Day. Probably not a good move, you know. Alcohol is never a great move. So my body has to get rid of it. Thank God I don't do that every day or every week. Not good. And slowly rolling up. The Vaughn, I'm giving a shout out to the Vaughn on Pratt Street, downtown Hartford, has homemade Irish cream. The best! And because it's COVID, you can take some home. Party hard, hard! Inhale up. Loving it! Exhale. Beautiful. Let's take it back to our chi flow. That's what I said. I was like, what? I can take it home? I was like, I'm in there. $20 a jar. I was like, oh yeah. When I get home, I'm gonna have me some Irish cream and coffee. Still sitting in there though, you know, but I think the alcohol preserves it quite well, la 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 la. Exhale, beautiful, peanut butter whiskey scattering, you can add that to it and take it to the next level, but right now, we are not talking about that, we are talking about cleansing, drinking our water, eating our fruits and vegetables, because we got to clean out our system after all of that mess. Let's take it to the left, bending bear to the left. I mean the right. Oh! You ever tell people take a right and they go left? I'm like, you don't know your right from your left, so check me out. Release that lower back. Oh, yeah. purchased, and it was a leaf, and it's starting to look like another kind of leaf. And everybody's like, what is that? I'm like, oh no. Inhale, exhale. That's the thing about milky stuff. It makes a lot of mucus, so I gotta cleanse my body. Parting Horse's Mane. I never do that all the time. You know what? Parting Horse's Mane is going to make us do a lot of movement. So, you know what we're going to do? We're going to go into Beautiful Woman, bends her waist, so open up. And we're going to do Heaven Hands today. That's easier. Yeah. We did the Chi Ball. So, if you don't feel comfortable with your hands on the back of your waist, that's okay. You can leave them down. And, you know, remember, pick what's comfortable for you. You know, put the weight on the outside of your feet. Always try to do that because you start to engage your sartorius muscle to your right. We're going male focus today. A little male energy. I like a little male energy. Inhale up. Exhale. It completes me. It's a balance to my female energy. Remember, sit back a little bit in that chair because you want to fall forward. Especially if you're going full throttle with your knees and lower back. Inhale up. You can hold on to your chair too if you don't want to hold on to your back. It's a choice. Exhale, inhale, good. And now we're just gonna use that waist, ready? And exhale, inhale, exhale. I met a carpenter in Astoria today, might have really called this person. I want somebody to put my plants in the ceiling. Exhale. Now that we're feeling a little bit better about people coming around us, inhale. And exhale, use that waist. Add that waist. That waist is where your abs are. And it really works. Inhale up. Being consistent for a year has been a blessing. Even though I can't do like that kind of, you know, that whole jumping around Zumba, I can't do that with my knees. But I can move my upper body. Inhale. I can move my legs slowly. And guess what? You're seeing the difference, the transformation, so it means it's working. Inhale up. Exhale. That's the thing about you're doing it, really doing the exercises, because when you just kind of fake it, it doesn't work. Inhale. One more time. Two more times, okay? I'm going to stand up for this set. Ready? Just take that left hand, moving that waist again. This is slow. Inhale. Hey, how about some of us, if you're not able to, you don't have to, inhale up, exhale, we're going to move. I'm going to do it standing first, and then I'm going to do it in a chair. Inhale. So if you're in your chair, just stay with this. Now I'm going to bring my right leg in, inhale, as I'm turning to the left. So I'm going to shift my weight over. I'm going to step my left leg out. Yeah. Inhale. I'm going to shift my weight over. Bring my right leg in. And now I'm going to stay right here. Inhale. And now I'm going to step. Ready? This time we're going to stay right here. Now we're going to step out on the right foot. Inhale. Right foot steps out. My left leg in. Last one. Inhale. Step my right leg up. Beautiful. Let's stay right here. All right. Let's try that again, but this time I'm going to do it in the chair. Yeah, we're flowing today. Ready? Ready? So inhale. Now this in the chair, you're only moving your leg in and out. So. Bring the left leg and you'll be moving it in a very weird way. So you're doing the same leg but twice. Inhale, you're in the chair, just open up that left leg. You're sliding it. Now inhale, it's coming back. So that's how you do it in the chair. I'll do it one more time in the chair. It's different from inhale. You're moving that leg. And you move your ischias. Inhale, lean back. Yeah, last one, inhale. My arms are like, ooh, girl, what you trying to do? Well, I feel it. Inhale, and remember, lean back. Good, nice, beautiful. All right, shake it all out. Ooh. Oh. I'm gonna take it right into are you with me? All right. Picking up your, now if you're sitting in your chair, just pick up your, inhale. Now if you're in your chair, you're going to have to really pull your body up out of that chair. Remember, don't pick up your legs so high. You're not competing with anybody here. We're all working at our own fitness levels. And the only competition is the goals we set for ourselves. Exhale. Right. This opposite hand that's opening up is like an extra hand, a leg or a hand. There's energy shooting out your palm of your hand as you're pushing down on that right foot. Yeah, inhale. If you're in the chair, I will lean forward just a little bit and then straight up, not back. Remember, we don't want our lower spine to collapse. All right, I'm gonna do the last set right here, standing up. Mm-hmm, you feeling it? Inhale. I think I'm going to do reeling silk today because it encompasses all movement. Inhale. Just take your time. Let's put four moves together today. Alright, ready? We'll finish out with one set. I think we're gonna do the chi flow. Are you with me? Right. Going right into heaven hand. We'll even add beautiful person because their waist. Alright, just to shake it up a bit. And then we're gonna close out with flying geese. Golden rooster. So let's go right into reeling silk. Are you ready? Open up. Oh, great heart exercise. Elbows bringing them in. Inhale. Slightly bringing your body forward. Inhale up. Straighten the legs. Always keeping the knees nice. meditation together. Ready? I'm going to do it on the chair first, then I'm going to shake it out. Good. Ready? Let's start with commencing form. Inhale up. Exhale. I'm just going to be doing two and two. Inhale. Good. Now we're going to take it right into, ready? The Dantian. Open up the lid. Inhale up. Exhale. Right into golden rooster. Inhale. I would lean forward a little bit in the chair. Use your ab to pull that stomach muscle in. Last set. The flying geese. So let's review. We did commencing form. Dantian connection. Extended. The chi ball. Into flying geese. Really simple, my friend. Golden rooster stands on one foot. Inhale up. And closing out with reeling silk. Beautiful. One more. Inhale up. All right, I'm doing it one more set, but this time I'm doing it standing. All right, shake it out. Alright, ready? This is great stuff. You know, today when you get a chance to review and then go outside and just do it, put on some nice music. I put on slow jams if I don't have any of this Tai Chi music. Put on some slow jams. There you go, ready? We're taking it from the top. Commencing form. Inhale. Exhale. One more time. Through the nose, teeth at the top row, your tongue at the top. To our chi ball. Okay. Take it into the left side. Your right foot's going to step back. Okay. And exhale. Inhale, floating over. Turn that waist. Exhale. And inhale. Back to the chi ball so we can change sides. Love you, even though you're a challenge to my life. My brain is on. exhale. I'm losing it. To the right, I lost patterns. I started talking. I think we did. Moving right along. Are you with me, my friends? Just to make sure, I'm going to take it to the right side. Ready? Bringing my right foot forward. Here we go. Last one. And. Good. Open it up. Nice stretch. Inhale. Exhale. Remember, you can stay center if you don't want to use your leg. Stay right here. Or you can add the leg. I love it. Makes me feel like I'm a ballet dancer. Because it's so smooth. Let's take it right into Golden Rooster on the right. Okay, guys, we're going to get our bands next week. I'm going to try to add some bands. There we go. Ready? Reeling silk. So in therapy, right, to strengthen my outer legs and my muscles around my knee, they had me walk little tiny steps side by side. I thought I was going to die. My glutes was like, inhale up. I got to get back to my workout. Yeah, we got to do that. We got to ask for that good stuff. Good, good. That's Beyonce. Give me that good, good. Inhale up. Beautiful. Let's take it right here. Ready? Just take your arms and sit back right here. Stretch out your body. Just shoot your ischias out the back and contract. So here's a contraction. So I'm pushing in the upper part of my back, and now my back is flat. Not arched, but flat. There's a difference. And now, ready? Just gonna stretch, turn your torso a little bit to the right. Inhale, exhale, and shift. You're not shifting through your legs either. And contract. Let's take it again. Ready? Same thing happening here. Everything you do on the floor, you can do on your legs. Nice. Ready? Contract. Ooh, I feel a crack. I'm like creak crack. Ooh, I feel it better in the chair, only if I can feel it down on the earth. Oh, one more time. Contract. Beautiful. Last one. And now this one, when you do the contraction, I want you to bring it right here center. Bring your feet, same thing standing. Bring your feet down a little bit. And take it into a nice chair pose. This is a yoga pose. You can straighten your arms out, but it adds stress to the shoulder. I say nay. With the nose and exhale, remember your tongue behind the front row of your teeth. Bring your fingertips in, pull up. Sit up on those ischias. Try not to be slouching or like, you always see the girls pushing your stuff, your tail out. No, just sit on top. Feel that? Bring your legs a little closer together, just a little, not much. Inhale. Push down on your right foot and up and over like a candy cane. Nice stretch. Try not to let the hands come in, but keep them out. Oh, I didn't even wear my sweater this winter. I'm gonna try to wear it tonight. Inhale. I just didn't wear it. I made a whole sweater to wear for the winter and I never did. Push down on the left foot, leaning up and over to the left. This one's dedicated to Deaconess Rose, my sister's mother-in-law. Inhale up. She was a matriarch of the family. You know, we've had a few. Now my brother is the patriarch. Aunt Hattie is another matriarch of our family. Inhale up. Exhale. Diane is becoming another one. And my sister. It's always by the oldest. Inhale up. Nice. Beautiful. And just open up those arms. Let them rest. Oh, nice. those shoulders forward.
Yep.
You know, when somebody's lived about 70 or 80 years, I say they got something to say. What you say? And it warrants listening. Stop, you know, always trying to insert your opinion. You know, give the elders some respect. You know, hear what they gotta say. At the end of the day, you're only gonna do what you take from it. Mm-hmm. Take those arms a nice stretch back.
Right.
A lot of us, you know, you take something good, you maybe take a salt. Maybe you might take the whole thing because you realize, shoot, I need all of this. It depends. Yeah. Oh, lovely. All right, we're gonna get some arm work in, huh? So if you want, by the way, grab your water. I say, I was trying to include it in our class. Nice water break. He creates molds and he talks about the scriptures, but it's about the potter's wheel. And then I heard about it when I was reading Jeremiah today. And it was talking about how, you know, you can be shaped by great energy, you know, for you all that are not as religious. But for us that are, well, I don't consider us religious, it's just don't believe in God. But if us, you do, you believe that God shapes you, you know. Some of us believe in positive energy. I ain't mad at you. You know, we all have choices. Let's take those cans, right, and we're not going to clench them because that's not putting pressure in your hands. We don't need that. Just let them rest there, yeah. And leave your arms. Everything in aerobics is about 45-degree angles, okay? So you're only going to bring your arm up to a 45-degree angle from your elbow. Ready? Inhale. Exhale. It's called calisthenics. You don't have to use them at all. Inhale on the way down. Exhale on the way up. Good. Remember, put the weight on the outside of your feet. Sit up on those ischii. Let's hold on for a minute. While you're holding them in your hand, I want you to tighten the glutes. Tighten, release. Tighten, release. Tighten, release. Hold it right up there again. Inhale. Exhale. I actually am taking my arms and pressing them against my side of my body with this part of my arm, so I'm really holding tight, engaging my biceps. And now right here, remember, if you want to do two, that's fine. Hey, we're all working at our own fitness level. Just follow. And exhale. Inhale. Sit up on those ischii. Don't collapse. Good. Release it. Good, I'm gonna stand up for this one just so I give a different view. You're still on your ischii. Even though you're in that chair, you should be tightening those ischii. There's no reason why you can't do that. I'm sorry, no excuse for that one. If you're standing, you're tightening your ischii too. Put the weight on the outside of your feet. Squeeze those glutes. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze them. Hold them. There we go. You're gonna bring your arms up to a 45-degree angle. Inhale. Now I'm gonna use a little shoulder right here. If that's too much for you, don't do it. Go back to the bicep curl. Inhale. Bring it right towards your side. Inhale. Yeah. Inhale. Remember, never higher than your shoulder. Everything's on a 45-degree angle. It's all about angles in this exercise. Inhale. Next, last one. If you want to join us, you can. If you don't, remember, we're all working. Don't lock out your joints. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, last one, inhale, exhale. What's happening with your glutes? Did you let them go? Bring them in. Yeah, you can't do that. Right here, hold it right here. Just gonna move it up. Like a W, I like it. Inhale, exhale. Bicep and tricep. Inhale. What I also do is add a little ab in here because I pull my abdomen. I try to push that abdomen muscle in when I exhale. Inhale. I lift up my rib cage. Exhale. Squeeze that glute tighter. And inhale. Release it a little bit. Good. Nice. Drop it back. Good. Bring those elbows back. Inhale. Right by your side. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. there's two ways to approach this, right? You can put one down, one can down, and you can take your lean. You can just rest right here and bring that elbow right here at the shoulder level and just extend. Inhale. And so you're saying to yourself, what do I do in the chair? The same thing. The same thing. Okay. Off the floor. If you want to take it to the next level, you can. Up and touch. try not to use your quad, but you should start to arm muscle. If you're in the chair, you might want to open your leg just a little bit and up and touch. You don't need to do that if you're standing up. If you're standing, you are in a different situation. You are here. So you're going to just lift. Ready? Up and touch. And when I say touch, that means you don't sink into the floor. What we want to do is just drop the foot. No. Up and touch. That quad. Up and touch. And up. How about your abs? Are you holding them in? Are you using your glute that you're standing on? Yeah, remember. Remember, you can stop and begin again. I'm just going forward because I'm able to do it. But if you're not, remember, we're all working at our own fitness levels. We're not in competition. Okay. Good. Bring it back in. Bring your body all the way down. Oh.
Release that spine. Hold up. Inhale.
Tai Chi posture. Commencing form. Shift your weight. Side, tighten those glutes. Ready? Let's put the weight on that right leg now. Sliding this left leg out. Good. And bring it in. It's slightly on the floor. It's not really on the floor. That's why you're able to lift it up. In ballet, you would lift that hip up so that we can do our tendu. Yes. All right. And you're going to turn that hip. Your whole trochanter bone. It's a huge bone in your hip. That's what's turning. It's not turning from the knee. It's actually turning up here in the hip. If that's too much for you, don't do it. Hey, we're all working at our own fitness levels. Remember, you want to use the inner thigh to lift. And if you're standing, put the weight on the outside of the foot. Lift up and touch. Up and touch. It's almost like a tendu, to be honest with you. Touch. Remember, you don't have to bring it up that high. Touch. Good. And good. And hold it right there. Bring it back. Nice stretch over. Chair, you want to hold on, you want to do it here, you want to flex, turn that leg, put that weight with that, put some of that weight on the leg in, and out, use that hip, get both hips out and lift, up, lift with your heel in this exercise, try not to let your spine go, collapse, but keep it up there, hold on to the chair if you need to, up, and up, you see this muscle right here, you should feel it. Up, not the knee, not the quad. It has nothing to do with this. Up, touch. Remember, if you can do two, yay! Good. Open up those legs nice and wide and stretch. If you're standing, you're doing the same thing. You just know I have a chair. Nice stretch. Good. Just open up them. Take that arm. Don't push down on your muscles in your leg. Just let stretch. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Yep. Exhale. Last one. We're going to take it all the way around now. Nice stretch. Changing arms. Taking that right arm. Good. Let's take it again. Ready? Nice stretch. Oh. Ooh. Put your arms. I feel that all. I feel it all back here. Really good stretch. Kidneys never get any stretching. Alright? You're standing. You're nice here. Ready? And we're gonna stretch. Over and in here. You know this way before? No. Inhale. Good. We're gonna take it all the way around, my friends. Nice stretch. Take that right arm. Shift. We're not shifting legs, just the body. Try it again. You know what I'm learning now? I'm going to get into meditation because that really brings joy, doesn't it? Turn your feet in by putting your legs in a stretch. Let's take a nice bending beer here. Inhale. Exhale. Put the weight on the outside of your feet. Rolling up. Inhale up. Woo! A lot of exercise jumping back and forth. sit on the shoulders. Reverse. We had a little longer workout than normal, but we're going to finish up with a nice stretch. And let's go forward. And again, try not to let your body turn. Like keep the shoulders square. Just lift your arm up. There you go. And don't hold on to the wrist or the elbow, but just a nice stretch forward. Try not to bend it. I see people doing this. What's the point? There's no point in that. Okay, extend it and just nice stretch. You'll feel a stretch right here in the arm. Stretch. Inhale and breathe with it. And exhale. What's happening with your glutes? Are you like slouching? Sit up. The more you get, the more you work on sitting up, the better your abs and your glutes will be. The more time you slouch, you're really hurting your lower back. You're adding pain. Stop adding pain. Don't do it. Let's take it here. You can do it here. Nice stretch. Just keep doing some stretch. Remember, I'm never holding onto the joint. Nice stretch. Don't let your body turn. Keep it nice facing me. If you want to deepen it, you can stay right here. If you want to deepen it, you can just take that hand and let it sedate. But of course, what happens is your head wants to do this. So you have to press your head against your arm. I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm going to a conference on Saturday or whatever it is. But, you know, a girl got to get her hair beaded. I got to check into it. But I learned how to premiere an exercise class. I can do a fresh exercise class during the day and then put it up for that day. How cool is that? Yeah. So maybe I'll do a super class. Nice stretch. Nice stretch. Reach those arms out. Oh, hard, 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 hard. Good. Bring it right here. Nice stretch. Control. Good, let's take it on the other side. All right, my friends, take that left arm. All right, switch forward. And remember, don't hold on to the joint, but hold on in between the wrist and the elbow. Nice stretch. You should feel a nice stretch right here. If you're turning, you're not going to feel it. So you got to keep your shoulders facing. Nice stretch. And just deepen it. Remember, don't hold on to the joint. Nice stretch. Just let this hand hang over like a sack of potatoes. Put the weight on the outside of your feet. Use your glutes right here. Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm on a glute trip. And drop your hand behind the back of your head because what happens is your neck wants to go forward, so you have to press your, and you don't hold on to the joint like we said before, so lifting your chin away from your neck. Nice stretch. If you can, you can reach your hand, great. I can't do it, I'm sorry. The hand is like, where is it? I can't find it. Having a fight back there. I don't care. Nice stretch. And nice stretch out. Oh, I can't believe it. You know, I stood in line actually and cut the line. I ain't gonna lie. I got in line so I could be able to get my granddaughter to see Obama when he was going to go for office. And I ended up, she was only a couple months old. And I was able to give her to him and he held her and he took pictures with her. I was like, wow! It's a pivotal moment in my life. I wish I could have done it with all my grandkids, but you know, you always get one that does something different from the other. I have 7 wonderful grandchildren, actually 9. My son has 2. Let's drop our ear to our left shoulder. They all have unique abilities. They all are smart. I'm blessed to have smart grandchildren, every last one of them. They all have a special gift. And I'm discovering each one. They all have a different gift. I just have to take time. It's 7 people, you know? Yeah. Up. Nice. Drop your left ear. Your left ear to your left shoulder. Chin down your chest. Right ear to the right shoulder. Yeah. Now, bring it up and over to your left. Now, bring it up and over to your right. Yeah. Stretch out that neck. Chin to your chest. I think that's life, trying to figure out all the wonderful gifts that are around you. You don't even know it, you know? Some of you are blessed. You know, you're really blessed to even just have one. 7 for my. Yeah. But I love it. I think my grandson is like a supersonic. Him and my granddaughter Akiva and Kamaya, they're like, dun-dun-dun. They can jump, they flip, they hop. And Lynn, now I found out too. Hey, Linda is in Shalom, my Prissy girls. Oh, they're my family. Anaya's my time visual artist, but she dances too. She's just going through a mood change. Her and Kamaya now teenagers. So.
Lord have mercy on me.
You just have to go with the flow. Inhale. Turn your ear to your left. Inhale. Exhale. Stretch out that neck. You know, we don't stretch out our neck nearly enough. If you can clasp your fingers, actually, hold your fingers to your head. So your hands are pushing this way, right? Just with, to your right, push against them. And you'll feel a lovely stretch in the back of your neck. Your hand is pushing this way, so you're pushing this way. Let's change it. Stretch out that neck. Don't let your head take over. It's a fight. It's a fight to the bitter. And while you're there, could you pull your ab in while you're at it, you know? Squeeze that glute. I'm always trying to figure out how you put that in. Clasp your hands right here, and if it's possible, just take your hand right behind the back of your head and push your head. Your head's going back, and your hands are pushing this way. Nice stretch. You're feeling another wonderful stretch. Mm. Oh, yeah. They're all dancers, I have to tell you, every last one. I got dancers in the hands. Yes! And I love it, because they can move. They're very kinesthetically intelligent. Just clasp your fingers, and this time the hands are pushing this way, but your head is pushing forward. Yep. As a matter of fact, I danced with my oldest daughter all the way through. I taught aerobics at the time. And I danced with her until she kicked me and said, "Get off me." I was trying to do a straddle, and I guess it was too much for my stomach. I'm dancing, and with my other daughter, I danced, but I did more singing. And honey, she could sing. I also was a hairdresser then. She could do some high. So funny how artistic, whatever you're doing with your baby in your stomach or your womb, the children pick it up. Beautiful. Nice, nice, nice. Shake it all out. Oh. All right, my friends, you know what I didn't do is a lovely hamstring stretch. So I'm going to do it because I want it. How about you? Just sit in that chair. If you're standing, lay on the floor. Don't even mess around with the mess around. I'll do one in the chair, one on the floor. Just take your leg up. Again, you can do it at the ankles. Or you can bring it up like I like. Just a nice stretch. Circle that ankle. Inhale up and lean forward. Nice stretch. And really take some time with the stretch. Like, don't rush it. I think that's a lot of problems. We rush our stretches, and our body needs time to say, "Oh, are you stretching me now?" Kind of a thing. Yeah. Nice stretch. Take that leg. Oh, nice stretch. And you can either cross it over and release it, or remember, you can keep it right here. Choices. Or you can keep it on the floor. Release your spine. This is the time you can slouch. Inhale, turn your body to the right. That feels great. Good. And release. Nice. Let's take it on the other side. Ready? Nice stretch forward. Good. If you're on the floor, you can do the same thing, only this time I'm going to do it on the floor. Okay? I'm going to get down here. Oh, Lord, I don't think I can get back up. Yes, I can. You're going to take your left leg this time, my friends. Yep, lay on your back. I'm going to go right to the back. This feels great. Cross your leg. Remember, you can do it here. To me, it's a little point. But that's me. Remember, we're all working at our own fitness levels. And now, instead of bringing your body to your legs, you have to bring your leg to your bodies. Bring it up. Nice stretch. Stretching the hamstring. Circle that foot. Good. Nice. And it's different in the chair. You're going to cross over and release and turn and all that. On the floor, you just put your feet down and just drop your legs to the side. Oh, yeah. Nice stretch. Inhale up. You can also turn your head the opposite direction, the legs. This plant is really beautiful because it hangs around me. So all the plants next to me are so bountiful. I do talk to them and stuff. Hi, baby! And if you're in a chair, open up your legs and bring your body to your legs. Nice big hug. If you're on the floor, bring your legs to your body. Nice stretch. Ooh. If you're on the floor, nice stretch. chair, you're not going to stretch your legs out, but you're going to open your thighs like we did earlier. Just open up right here. But your legs are going to be bent.
Yep.
Nice stretchy to the side there. Open it up. Woo! Just, I feel it. Inhale, exhale. Nice. Put those legs in. If you're on the floor, do another one of these. Another set of these. Yep. If you're in the chair, I'm going to get up for my friends in the chair. Okay? Just because. I know I went over. Sorry. It felt good. We're getting out of here. Just watch it. I hope you did it. Just nice stretch. Yeah. All right. And as we began is how we end. We stepped into the Hall of Harmony with our right fist, open left palm, right under the left under the right, open up. We took a gentle bow, but we stepped forward with our right foot and forward with our left. In this one, we're going to step back with our left ischii in the chair and followed by our right. Thank you. I'm going to do it one more time for my friends that are standing and for my friends that are like, I can get up out of this chair. Because you can. Because you can. And here we go. You ready? So you're going to inhale just like you're doing reeling silk. We covered that today. This time, you remember how we do it? You let your body go all the way over, right? Let your hips do the work. Inhale. I look up. Ah, beautiful. We're going to do it twice. And we're going to do flying geese. And now bring your hands forward for commencing form. This is sitting down. Ooh, this is a great move. Yeah, but this time I'm going to stay up. Okay, ready? Let your body come all the way over. The weight in there. Lift up those hips. Inhale up. Beautiful. I'm going to take it right here. All right, my friends. We worked out. You know, sometimes you just got to make the workout work out. Take a right fist into open left palm. Right under the left. Left under the right. I've been doing some late life cleaning and working. Gentle bow. That's why I'm exhausted. Slowly rolling up. Let's step back out of the Hall of Harmony, as Scott Cole says, left foot followed by the right. Thank you. God bless you. You are so amazing. Let's make sure, my friend, you get your water in today. Don't play around with the mess around. Don't play around with the mess around. Thank you. I'm so glad you came with me today. Thank you. Forget to drink your water. Don't forget to take your vitamins. Keep your immune system up. Eat your vegetables and your fruits. And definitely get your peace of mind. God bless you. See you Saturday.